Friends, today I wish to make you aware about a very important health problem in the young all over India. You should all know that the highest incidence of heart attack is amongst the young of India all over the world. This is the recent WHO report. And now we have got a definite lines of primary prevention. That is, that if we take certain care right at the age of 9, 10 and 11 years of life, then we can prevent 50% of heart attacks in future. This has also been documented and tried in United States and other European countries. One important investigation which is so necessary in an individual who is likely to have a coronary heart disease or who has got a great tendency to get a coronary heart disease because of the family history. Over and above doing a lipid profile test, we can do one test which is very, very simple, without any side effect, without any encumbrance to the patient, and relatively inexpensive. It is known as coronary calcium score. Coronary calcium score can be done without injection of a dye in an advanced X-ray unit, and that can give a fairly good information about the state of coronary arteries. So this test must be done in a suspected individual. Coronary calcium score is sometimes done after giving an iodine injection, which is known as CT angiography. Now, CT angiography should not be taken lightly, because again, we inject iodine. And when we inject iodine, it's a stress on the kidney. And therefore, iodine use during the lifetime must be used only when it is absolutely necessary. When we know that this patient may require angioplasty or bypass surgery, then only we should do angiography. So we should limit the study of coronary arteries to coronary calcium score without the injection of dye. People say that how would we know what is the state of coronary arteries? It can be generally surmised only by coronary calcium score without injection of a dye. If we inject the dye, then it's a strain on the kidney. So we reserve even not a CT angiograph. That again we have to inject the dye. But we do this coronary angiogram only when, after studying the coronary calcium score and after giving the treatment for reducing his LDL cholesterol, if the patient and giving the proper treatment, if the patient continues to have chest pain and his ejection fraction of the heart, ejection fraction is again a great thing to understand, which is known as EF. A normal ejection fraction of a normal individual is 60%. When it says 60%, people think it is of 160%. No, 60% is 100%. So if any individual, the ejection fraction is more than 40 or 45, then that person can be treated medically. And from the coronary calcium score, we have some idea about the obstruction in the coronary arteries, and it can be treated very effectively with medicines. But when we think that he is not coming, his complaints are not coming under control, and his ejection fraction is less than 40, then an angiogram can be done. And at that time, the patient should be advised that this angiogram is being done, and if we find an obstruction, then he might have to undergo angioplasty or bypass surgery. So the whole idea is that we do angiogram and then find out whether he needs it or not is an erroneous idea. Before that, a test by lipid profile, clinical examination, the results of the effect of the treatment, and coronary calcium score without the injection of dye are the prerequisites, and they can be done. And then treatment and ejection fraction. And if treatment is effective and if the ejection fraction is more than 40, then he should continue medical treatment, and no angiogram, that is angiography, should be done. It is now recorded that the young of India has got the highest incidence. They get heart attack between the age of 25 and 50. All of a sudden, they are very healthy outwardly, and during stress or any other reason, they get all of a sudden heart attack. But now we have got a complete knowledge about the cause of heart attack in the young and ways to prevent it. And that is the subject of my talk today. People who get the heart attack at young age, their family members, the blood family members, that is parents and blood relations of parents, they get the heart attack or stroke below the age of 70. That is known as a positive family history. And in such people, at the age of 9, 10, and 11, if parents and children are taught the importance of physical activity and healthy diet, it does not mean that at that young age we have to make the diet very, very, what we call it, without any taste or put all sorts of restrictions so that the children cannot enjoy the diet. That's not the idea. Let them enjoy the diet. But the basic knowledge that over-fried foods and the fast foods, they are not healthy for the coronary arteries of the heart. As you all know, that the heart supplies blood to the whole body. But heart to function requires the blood itself. And this blood comes from the top of the heart, from where the blood comes out from the main artery. And from that main artery, two arteries come out, right and left. They are known as, because they come from the top of the heart, they are known as coronary. Coronary means head, mugat. So, crown. Therefore, they are known as coronary arteries. And these two coronary arteries, right and left, they supply blood to the heart muscle. And that makes the heart muscle work incessantly for us. So, this to keep these coronary arteries healthy is the challenge today in India especially. Because you must all understand that young of India are the wealth of the world. Not only wealth of India, but the wealth of the world. And it has been proven that the United States, today the contribution of young people of India in the progress is phenomenal. That's the same thing in Canada, Australia, or England. And these people, they live under a lot of stress because of their competence, and the stress is very common to all of them. And because of the stress, the one habit which is easy to form to reduce the feeling of, reduce the effect of stress is tobacco in any form, chewing tobacco, smoking tobacco, rubbing tobacco, or whatever form. And tobacco, it has now been proven that increases the tendency for getting heart attack 20 times more than the usual tendency. So we have to see that right from the childhood, the child, as they grow old, they cannot fall prey to this tobacco habit. So the subject that I am going to touch today is that we have got to educate the parents and the children right at the age of 9, 10, and 11. Therefore, in schools, this whole idea of primary prevention of the illness and stress management must become one part of the curriculum. And I'm very happy to tell you that we have instituted a program of stress management for last 27 years. And it so happened that it started on 2nd October 1991. And in this year, which is the 150th year birthday anniversary, we feel that this Gandhian program, I call it a Gandhian program because this program is so simple and yet very effective. And Gandhi liked everything which is simple and effective to the last man, to the last common man. That was his talisman. That was his talisman. Gandhi said that anything I do must help the last man. So this program is simple, easy to do and absolutely inexpensive. So, and that program has come to be known as Universal Healing Program. And now we have got a website, Universal Healing, one word, universalhealing.org. And on that website, we have put all our literature, all the video films, all the instructions, and all our books, which are free to be downloaded from that website. So, what shall we do then? How will we find out that this particular family, the children, are excessively prone? We can do one test of lipid profile, that measures the amount of cholesterol, and the cholesterol has two types. One is the HDL cholesterol, other is LDL cholesterol. Now the LDL cholesterol now is become the most important to be seen because it is the culprit cholesterol. When the LDL cholesterol is higher than 70 milligram, then in a positive family history, that can cause deposition in the coronary arteries in early age and may result in heart attack. So, and of course, along with that, the stress of the that is so common today. So, we should institute such dietetic habits which will not increase LDL. And that is a common knowledge that fast food and excessive use of simple carbohydrates, that is excessive use of sweets, sugar, and excessive use of saturated fats, that is fried food, fast food, can increase LDL. So that can be controlled. And other thing is that they may not, due to stress, we have to be careful that they may not fall prey to tobacco habit. Now to reduce stress, as I said, we have got a program now which has come to be known as Universal Healing Program. It's a program which teaches a method to quieten our body and mind and become one with our breath, which breath is common to all of us. So when we quieten our body and mind and become aware of our breath, that is our program. It's very simple and you can learn it from our links, from our presentation on the YouTube. And if you practice that, it requires very little time, about 20 minutes a day for doing only Savasana. And the whole program of little exercises so that the Savasana can be better can be done in 40 minutes. And we have found out something interesting, that if you do this program, the whole program, even the parents can start it and children can do it also. And if they do the whole program, which makes about 40 minutes, and if they do it in a group of three people is a group, and 300 is the same, then it can be done only twice a week at the interval of 3 days, Monday and Thursday or Tuesday and Saturday, and that way, either in the evening or in the morning at any time for 40 minutes in a group, then also it shows a great effect in reducing the stress or overcome the stress. A feeling of oneness which comes when we do this program, it really increases, not only reduces stress, helps the coronary arteries, but also promotes universal brotherhood. Universal, which is a very good side advantage of this program. And therefore it has come to be known as Universal Healing. We started this program for coronary heart disease. And it was started first in the United States by Dr. Dean Ornish. And the program was taught to him by Swami Sachinananji, who was a disciple of Dr. Sivanand Swami. And I had an opportunity to learn that program in 1991. And that was in 25th June 1991. I became aware of that program in the United States. And immediately after that, on 2nd October 1991, here, I started the similar program. And this program is now, as I said, is becoming a universal healing program. So the dietetic habits also is a part of the program. We have got five elements in the program, which we have discussed. The diet, light stretching and relaxation exercises, going to progressive deep relaxation, savasana, and meditation. So these 5 points in the program, which you can learn from our website or in the form of publications, easy to do. So I'm trying to explain the importance of this for every family, and more in the family where there is a family history of getting a heart attack or a stroke at young age. And that family history means that in blood relations of that child, the stroke or heart attack has occurred below the age of 70. So now I would like you to understand one thing, that the whole program is my great feeling that it is a very important health issue for the whole nation, and it should be given a great priority in teaching in the school curriculum. And that's my effort. When I came home this year on 17th of July or 16th of July, before that I met Dr. Nissen, a very famous cardiologist of USA, who is the expert in primary prevention, and he talked with me for about 15 minutes, and that talk is also on a video on a YouTube, and I will send you the link about that. And that in that dialogue you will understand how Dr. Nissen was very anxious that the whole of India should start primary prevention, and that's why he said that this should become a national priority, national health priority. So thank you very much for your attention. Please understand this and see that the simple program that I like to teach you or make it popular, you will get it from this link which I am going to provide to you, or from my publications which are easy to download from universalhealing.org. Thank you all. It has been a great pleasure talking with all of you, and I'll be happy if the authorities who are the executive authorities of this country, they take note of this and make this whole program popular throughout India. It is the need of the hour.